This is Blue Note, Mid-Atlantic. 40 feet of sailboat, 4 sails, 4 crew. We've been at sea for 11 days, and we're taking a break for a swim, 1,000 miles from the nearest land, in a place where the water is 3 kilometers deep. And this is where our voyage began, Mindelo in the Cape Verde Islands. Almost Africa, not quite European. Something special. Very nice people, and a good place to set out from. The crew, moments before departure, Nerit, Chris, Yael, and Marco. And if we'd been lost at sea, I guess this is the photo you would have seen on TV. Friends who don't sail often ask us, so what do you do at sea for 2 weeks? First of all, keeping the yacht heading in the right direction, trimming the sails, navigating, all takes up a lot of time. There's time left over for fishing. This one here is a mahi-mahi. The crew has to eat, catch up on sleep, and all the important tasks of sailing, keeping the yacht going, carry on throughout the hours of darkness as well. We don't stop for the night. Spare time off watch is spent relaxing, often with a book, although the choice of reading material might surprise you. Our destination is the Caribbean, but we set a course south towards the equator to avoid an area of light wind in the mid-Atlantic. And as soon as we're able, we set up the spinnaker, Blue Note's biggest sail, to help speed us on our way. There's no such thing as smooth sailing. Things on board yachts have a habit of going wrong. And this time, it was our only toilet, blocked and out of action for 48 hours. Generally speaking, there are no plumbers at sea. But we did find a scientist.
And this goes back to the
like most systems on board a 40-foot sailboat, the plumbing is fiddly and hard to reach. The pipes proved impossible to unblock. So eventually Marco rigged up a bypass from some spare hose sealed with epoxy. On the third attempt, success. The toilet flushes.
You see water flowing.
So what did we do while the only toilet was out of action for 2 days? Here is the bucket and chuck it method. Down south we go, pointing all the time at the northeast coast of Brazil. After 7 days, Marco analyzes weather data and decides it's time to change course. These are the trade winds, and for most of the year, they guarantee fair weather and downwind sailing from West Africa to the Caribbean.
Click auto.
Carefully, we bring Blue Note around onto the opposite tack and reset the sails. This is the only course change we'll make for the entire 2,500-mile crossing. The boat and the crew pretty soon settle down to the new course. To provide some intellectual stimulation, Marco had brought along a sextant. For three centuries before the age of electronics and satellites, this was the best tool navigators had for calculating their position at sea. We all know the principle of celestial navigation, but could we actually get it to work in practice? A sextant measures the angle from the horizon to either the sun, the moon, or a known star. You need this angle,
Mark,
and an accurate time check in UTC.
54:26.
A nifty computer program takes the headache out of spherical trigonometry. Marco enters the observed angles and recorded times, and pretty soon we're amazed to see that by sextant, we know where we are to within 3 miles of the position being given us by the GPS. It's now January the 2nd, and perfect sailing weather makes it sad that this voyage will soon be over. All too soon, it's time to furl the sails. The ocean changes from deep blue to turquoise and is suddenly shallow. We make landfall at Virgin Gorda, close by one of our favorite bars. And for the first time in 17 days, we're reminded that we're not alone. The anchor chain rattles down, and we've made it.